getting rid of all the live ammo, because we're going to be using simunitions for this. Everybody gets patted down. It's just what you have to do when you're doing force-on-force training.
Greg Lappin is experienced in law enforcement, VIP protection, and overseas service. Let's see what we can learn when he goes up against four armed intruders in a shoothouse.
I've got some 5.56 simunitions marking cartridges to deliver some love to these fine gentlemen. Obviously, simunition has these little inserts that you put into the cylinders. That way they will not accept live rounds. And then I'm marking the pistols that have been converted. So even though we don't have any live weapons in here, there's gonna be no mistake. I do not want anyone to really go clear a structure or a house by themselves. This is probably the most dangerous thing you can do, hands down. And there's a reason that SWAT teams, special operations teams, clear structures with multiple people. With that being said, there's always a caveat to everything. What if your child's up there? You hear them screaming. What if your wife or loved one's up there? I'm gonna go. So let's give you a couple of tips to allow you to do it as safely as possible. Well, I'm gonna strap all this stuff on. And I've got four people upstairs hiding in rooms that I'm not aware of where they are, and I'm gonna go hunt them down. And I'm probably gonna get shot a few times too, but that's just the reality of things, you know? You guys got your guns?
Yeah.
Right? There's a series of rooms back here in the rest of the shoot house. You guys each go find one room, one to a room. All right, four of y'all, one of me. You can get 60 seconds. 60 seconds, I'm coming.
Cool. I hate it when he sounds like that. Like, I see his face, like, going, washing over. And, like, he's eating this up, too.
Oh, yeah.
What are you wearing, dude?
Nothing. Let's do this.
All right.
All right. I'm on it.
Wake me up when you guys are ready. I'm going to take a nap.
Force-on-force exercises should be done only under the direct supervision of an experienced trainer who is specifically certified in this area.
Yeah, you wanna keep fighting, sucker? Play stupid games, win stupid prizes.
Oh yeah, now what? Index, index, index.
Greg pulled everyone together. There was a lot to learn once they reviewed the video.
I'm expecting one of you to be right there. That first one's a bad room because it's center fed. And it's got fairly deep corners. I was waiting for someone to pop out down the hallway, so this is why you don't do one-man CQB pretty much ever. Like, bang, quick peek, and now I've directed my attention to those desks. Just trying to be as quiet as possible, you know, figuring I'd hear movement if you tried to pop up on the desks. So I came up, doors closed. I checked that little bit of crack. There was a little tiny crack I could kind of see. I bypassed it to check around the corner, and I'm going back because now I'm not worried about one of you guys waiting in the hallway. I push it, there was obviously something stuck. I actually thought it was just stuck on the rubber floor. So boom, I give it that boot. And that's where I see you, boom. And you can see I put my rifle right up in the crack of the door.
Yep. So did you see him through the crack?
I just saw his light flash. I said, oh yeah.
Oh, you mind. You got nowhere to go either. You got nowhere to go. So I checked that again, because now you're hearing shooting. I was expecting someone to maybe come out of the room. I get tucked in that hallway, start pine. You can see my rifle's all tucked in and broken down. Boom, this is where I get KJ, bang, bang.
You got me a lot there.
Yeah, and now I'm just driving.
See ya.
And you see what I did? Like, his gun was still pointed at me, so I just continued to maneuver on him.
Yeah.
Ran dry, transitioned to the pistol, which I wasn't happy about. I wish I had a magazine, because I would have reloaded inside that room. So I'm pieing. This is where I see you. Bang, bang, malfunction. I tucked back in behind the doorway, which I wasn't happy about. I was praying that you didn't hear me working my slide and take something. And then I just drove bang.
Straight to the temple.
See ya. Had another malfunction, tucked back in, cleared the malfunction. Checked my magazine before I go out. Yep, I was good. Same thing. Pying around. I see you right there. Bang, bang, malfunction, tucked back in. Again, bang, bang, and initiative, take the initiative and go. Drove back in, he fired a couple, had another malfunction. He fired like two rounds and ran out of ammo. You know, traditionally Sims have malfunctions. That's just the nature of the beast when you're dealing with any paint marking cartridges from any of the companies. You have malfunctions with them occasionally, and you just gotta work through it, so. The key to winning fights of any fight, whether it's a fist fight or a gunfight, is seizing initiative. The second I engage you, if you notice, the second I engage you, I took advantage of that and I basically maneuvered on you in every single case. The reality is, you know, I still got hit. You know, he got a glancing blow off the top of my helmet. This isn't like John Wick. This isn't like Hollywood. Like, you know, you get into a gunfight, you're probably gonna get shot. You know, like regardless of skill, or catch some frag or something. Something bad's gonna happen.